Those strong winds pelted both sides of the state line tonight.
The first reports of storm damage coming in tonight from Lawrence. KMBC 9's Martin Augustine is there live. Martin?
Laura, live here on the corner of 14th Street and Massachusetts, where these stoplights right back here went out about 5 o'clock this afternoon, only coming back on about an hour ago. Just one sign of the trouble literally blowing through here. The same storm hitting Lawrence smacked Lee's Summit. From News Chopper 9, you see the wind scattering what looks to be building material and splintering fences too, leaving behind the same sort of damage back in Lawrence. Here the wind doing a number on the fence of Chris Moore just when his evening was about to wind down. He was heading out the door to pick up dinner for his family when he got the word.
I was stopped in the middle of the street by one of my neighbors and told that 4 sections of my fence had already blown over.
The storm not only postponed dinner, but canceled whatever plans he had for Saturday and Sunday.
My weekend is pretty much planned out now. I'm going to be fixing the fence.
The rain was sideways. I mean, you know, like you'd be in a hurricane.
Larry Caldwell could see the trouble coming.
You can tell by the pole there that we had some pretty high winds.
While he never lost power, seeing what was happening to utility lines got him worried about his red machine shed on his farm just south of Lawrence, where his son, Kent, works on his race car.
And I was in the shop. I said, you know, I know the shop's pretty sturdy, but, you know, it was getting pretty bad. So it was nip and tuck for a while, I think.
For a time, nearly all of busy Massachusetts Street here was without power, but now the electricity's back on. Reporting live in Lawrence, Martin Augustine, KMBC 9 News. Larry and Laura.
Thanks, Martin.